What's up, guys? You're welcome to Emacom TV, where we publish news on politics and entertainment. All right, guys, I have a trending news for you today, and the protests in Edo State have snowballed into a serious revolution. And guess what? These guys in Edo State, in fact, they are chanting, Buhari must go. And guess what? They carry a coven. You get it? They carry a coffin in their protest and are chanting Buhari must go. And the governor of Edo State, Obaseki, have declared a curfew. The curfew is to start from 4 o'clock today. And in that news I did, I said that Governor Obaseki should have actually borrowed leave from what Wike did in banning protests in Edo State. Did it work? It never worked. When Wike saw the troop of people that went to his office that day, he bowed to pressure and even joined the protests. So Obaseki here have issued out a 24-hour curfew in Edo State. But these guys are not backing down. They're not backing down. So I'm going to play the video and then you see for yourself. Let me play the video. Think I'm going to. All right, here's the video. Check this out. Just check this out. Look at the massive crowd. Look at, they're carrying coffin. You get, so guys are not smiling. The youth all over the nation are angry. You know, they have been shortchanged for a long time, and you know, to worsen the matters, the authorities are not even willing to dialogue with them. The authority, when we say dialogue, is to listen to them and do what they want. You get it? So I'm going to play it again. It's to listen to them and do what they want. You know, there are some demands of this youth. You understand me? That is immediate. That is, it can take effect within 24 hours to 5 days. And that is what the youth want to see. They want to see seriousness. They want to see the government of the day being serious in what they are doing. Like, for instance, okay, SARS have been disbanded. And the IG of police did not even wait. Tensions are still high. He went ahead to form another team again called SWAT. And you know what? The mentality of this youth is that same. You know, knowing our leaders or who they are, you get me? They think that these people are the same SARS of a thing. Is the same guys who were SARS, they are the one. You know, for instance, they have taken time to train this SARS guy for anti-robbery operation. So do you think that they will just sit down there and just disband them like that? So there is a lot of cover-up. For instance, you see that in the wake of the first demand by the protesters that most of these SARS be disbanded and the psychological check should be conducted on them to check if they were okay. Do you know that the IG of police acceded to that demand and actually ordered that all disbanded SARS to report at the force headquarters in Abuja for psychological examination? That was last week. But guess what happened? Just a few days ago, we saw the commissioner of police in Lagos debriefing the SARS guys, you get, and they were on police uniform. You get, he was addressing them. So, but are they not supposed to be in the force headquarters in Abuja for psychological checkup? They were not supposed to be in Lagos. They're supposed to be in the force headquarters. So, this another issue are one of the things that make the youth to not trust. There's an issue of mistrust. Yeah, there's seriously an issue of mistrust, and the youth are not actually trusting the government. They don't look at the government actually taking them serious. And that is why you see they are still on the streets. You get? And there is even somebody who even had an encounter, a youth coordinator, national youth coordinator, you get? He had an encounter with SARS. And this is happening after SARS have been disbanded. So some people have said that SARS have not been disbanded, and SARS is still alive, well and kicking. You get, SARS is still very much alive. That is why the youth, they know, and that is why you see they are still protesting. You know, these people are, they still want to hold people. This is an oppressive regime. So they still want to hold people in captivity so that they can rule and tread upon people. So these youth here have had it enough, and they can no longer take it again. And so therefore they are staging this protest. And so the one in Edo State is gradually snowballing into a revolution. You get? And the next thing you're going to see, the military are going to say that this is no longer peaceful. We saw Lai Mohammed, you know, actually saying that the protest is no longer peaceful and all of that, that the government cannot sit by and watch as, you know, anarchy reigns. You get? That's what Lai Mohammed said yesterday, you know, and he said that in the wake of the attack on Oyetola. You get, the governor of Osun State by talks that actually infiltrated the NSAS protest. But you see, the governor, knowing the truth, came out and set the record straight. Oyetola came out and said that it was not the NSAS protester that attacked him, but it was the talks, political talks that was hired. They were the one that attacked him. You get? So the government of the day, they are looking for every possible means to make sure that they gag this protest. You get? They are trying to give it a bad name so that they can actually, you know, launch an attack against them. That's what they want to do. And international community is actually watching. You get? Recently, both the United States, UK, European Union, and the United Nations have warned Nigeria against using force to end the protest. You get, but rather the people should listen to the youth. Just yesterday, a youth in Katsina State, in Katsina State or one of these states, staged an insecurity protest. They are not protesting against us, their own is insecurity. Do you know that DSS picked up that guy who organized it? They picked up the guy, and why they are not able to gag this revolution? All these protests, NSAS protests, there is no leader. There's no leader. You get? So this is rudderless. The people are just, I don't know, it's like it's a spirit that possesses everybody all around the nation. Today in Calabar, they've staged a protest, and even lawyers equally joined them. The High Court was shut down. So this is very serious, guy. Everybody is joining. Yesterday we saw women in Lagos join the protest. I mean, women joined. So at the end of the day, this regime is going to be toppled. People are restive. People are not comfortable. You know, some persons claim they own this country. You get? The Fulani claim they own this country. And you've been seeing them, they've been saying it, and the DSS have never arrested them, have never called them to order. But the DSS will go after people in the South, East, South, South, and even Southwest. You get? So that is a problem here. So that's a problem. So people are no longer comfortable with this regime, and they are calling for an end to this regime. So Buhari should have actually come out as a father of the nation. He would have come out personally to address this issue. He would have met with those people one-on-one, address this issue, and then put an end and carry out reforms that will put his name in gold. You get? So what do you guys think? Edo State, do you think that the curfew installed or that has been declared by Godwin Obaseki, is it going to hold? Please, I want to drop your comment below. Let me know what you think. This is Emma Crown TV. God bless you.